Side Story is one of the most loved musicals of all time, and its soundtrack is iconic.
Hold my hand and we're halfway there.
The Broadway production won 3 Tony Awards and a Grammy. Then came the 1961 big screen version, which garnered 10 Academy Awards, including Best Supporting Actor for the charming and talented George Chakiris, who very kindly introduced me to Oscar.
There it is.
Wow.
It's heavy. Yes, it is.
George's stellar showbiz career spanned 75 years. He made his movie debut at 12 at the famed MGM Studios. And to be surrounded by stars in that golden age of Hollywood was a dream come true for the aspiring actor.
It was fantastic. I couldn't believe I was there, and we got to see only Frank Sinatra walking down the street and so on, you know. Elizabeth Taylor when she was 16 and so on. It was wonderful, really wonderful.
A kiss on the hand, maybe quite continental, but diamonds are a girl's best friend.
George danced alongside Marilyn Monroe in the Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend number from the 1953 classic Gentlemen Prefer Blondes. It's one of the screen's most legendary scenes, and George got to witness up close the dedication the late screen goddess had for her craft.
In the shooting of that number, that was absolutely the thing that I noticed about her, was how concentrated she was on the work.
It's interesting you say that, George, because it's kind of Hollywood folklore that Marilyn would be late to set, that she wouldn't know her lines, and yet you were there with her and you saw her being so dedicated to her craft.
She was just quiet, concentrated, focused on work, and that's why she's so amazing. She is amazing. She is amazing.
My one love affair didn't get anywhere from the start.
George continued to dance in some of Tinseltown's biggest movie blockbusters, including White Christmas, and that's where fans started to notice his smouldering good looks.
It was a picture of the four guys around Rosie, and what some girls did was they clipped that picture out and circled me, and they sent it to the studio.
As a result, in rolled the mountains of fan mail, and so he was quickly given a movie contract with Paramount Pictures.
So that was absolutely a sort of heads up and a step in another direction, if you like.
60 years ago, George went from background dancer to seeing his name blazing up in lights with the release of the West Side Story movie masterpiece. George played Bernardo, brother of Maria, who was played to perfection by Natalie Wood.
The first time I saw her, she was only 23, and she was a stunningly beautiful young woman, naturally very beautiful. She didn't depend on makeup. She was beautiful.
I feel pretty, oh so pretty. I feel pretty and witty and gay.
She was professional, she was accomplished, she was wonderful to be around, she was generous, she was gregarious, she was friendly, she was just great. She was just great. I love Natalie Wood. I couldn't be otherwise, you know.
Somewhere we'll find a new way of living.
Richard Beamer played Natalie's love interest as Tony, but the magic and chemistry between the pair very quickly fizzled when the cameras stopped turning.
She wanted either Warren Beatty or Robert Wagner to play that role, and that, of course, didn't happen. And because of that, Natalie, from what we heard, didn't speak to him. Of course, he didn't speak to her either. That's just the way it happened.
Hold my hand and we're halfway there.
I never like to say anything remotely unkind about Natalie, because I think she was kind. But just as a professional person, I think she hoped for a while that somebody else could play that role. And maybe that's why she was not as friendly to him while they were working as it turned out.
Natalie Wood. Her body was found floating in the water yesterday off Santa Catalina Island in California.
The death of Natalie Wood in 1981 remains one of Hollywood's most shocking tragedies and mysteries, and her passing still haunts George to this day. How did you deal with that absolutely astounding news?
Well, yeah, I can remember exactly now where I was when that happened. I remember thinking, why don't we just turn back the clock and it won't happen, you know? It was shocking and horrible this, for anybody's life to end in that way. It upsets me now to even talk about it. And just not Natalie.
It's now six decades on from West Side Story's release, and the movie remains a phenomenon. The music, the star-crossed love story, and of course, the dancing, which led to a rather embarrassing wardrobe malfunction for George.
So when we were shooting the dance at the gym, the pants, they ripped in the back. So, and there were two pairs of trousers, so of course I was able to change into another pair of trousers. And then those ripped, and there was nowhere else to go. So what we ended up doing is I started wearing black tights under the torn trousers until they were mended for the next day. But it was funny, but it all worked.
I'll get to Terry's apartment.
Better get rid of your accent.
The West Side Story soundtrack spent 54 weeks at the top of the Billboard charts, making it arguably the longest run of any album in the top spot.
The winner is George Chakiris.
And with 10 Academy Award wins, including one for George, West Side Story remains the most Oscar-awarded movie musical in Hollywood history. What was that moment really like?
It's always hard to describe what that felt like. It's kind of a disbelief. The way I have tried to describe it over the years is, if you buy a lottery ticket, no way do you expect to win. It's impossible. But you kind of hope that you might. It was just a wild, wonderful moment. It was just incredible. I'm so grateful for it, and awesome.
Who keeps him nicely polished and golden?
You know what? I've never done anything. He's stayed this way since the moment I got him.
Is a place for us.
At the end of the year, a remake of West Side Story will hit the big screen. It's directed by Steven Spielberg and is much anticipated, even for its original Oscar-winning star.
One of the trailers, and it just looks really beautiful. It looks exciting.
I think I go back to San Juan.
I know a boat you can get on. Bye-bye.
George looks back at his mighty career in his new memoir, My West Side Story, with incredible stories of the many icons and legends he's worked with.
Again, I've just been so lucky to meet such wonderful people and be able to work with such wonderful people, to get to know such wonderful people.
And you know what? It does go to prove that dreams can come true, doesn't it?
Yes, that's the thing I love so much. And I'll tell you, until I wrote the book, I don't think I ever stopped to think about it, but I thought about it since, and I thought, how amazing that some dreams came true.